Salutations, celestial sightseers. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. So what's up this week? Seeing double in Cygnus, and the young moon makes an evening appearance. It doesn't take long after dark in the summer for the Milky Way to be well up in the sky. But wait, you say, I can't see the Milky Way. That's okay. Seriously, there's lots to see. You just need to know where to look with a little help from binoculars or a small telescope. Let's start at one of the brighter stars in summer. Look for Deneb and Cygnus, rising in the northeast after dark. At the top of the cross shape of Cygnus, there are some stars that form the outline of wings, curving from the tips through Deneb here, and then around to the other tip. Let's zoom in on the wings section, starting on the northwestern one. Using binoculars, start at 2.9 magnitude Delta Cygni and curve partway towards Deneb, stopping at a wide and colorful double star right here. These two are the orange-yellow looking Omicron 1 and the bluish 30 Cygni, though strangely, Omicron 2 is another orange-yellow looking star nearby, this one here. At magnitude 3.8, Omicron 1 should be an easy spot in binoculars, as should the 4.0 Omicron 2 and the 4.8 star 30 Cygni. These stars are all quite distant, ranging from 700 to 1300 light years away, but they also speak to how bright and powerful Deneb is, which sits at 3200 light years away, but is visually brighter to us than those three stars by 10 to 25 times. Taking a nearly straight line from the Omicrons past Deneb to the other northeastern wing of Cygnus, but leaving Deneb in the edge of your field of view, place 3.7 magnitude Xi Cygni on the other side of the field. There's a beautiful section of the Milky Way here with many 5th through 7th magnitude stars that can even be seen from city locations with simple binoculars. Now, all in the same field of view, take a turn from Xi towards New Cygni here, then go to 61 Cygni, a short 4 degrees away this direction. 61 is a fantastic double star in a telescope, and the components are relatively near to us, just 11 light years away. In the same field as 61 are Tau Cygni here, and the difficult to say five times fast Sigma Cygni. This is another powerhouse of a star that is 43 times the size of our sun, at over 2,000 light years away, and a likely supernova candidate as well, though probably not anytime soon. Consider the slight single magnitude difference in brightness of 61 and Sigma, but the huge difference in distance between the two. Another thing I like about this area is the 7th through 9th magnitude stars around the Sigma, Tau, 61 Cygni area that are like a celestial spider web, but you'll need some dark skies or a rich field telescope to really see its full glory. And now this week's dark sky fact. Save on your electric bill, a 40-watt light bulb in a full cutoff fixture can be as effective as a 100-watt light bulb in a normal fixture. Very young moons can be challenging to spot, but pointers make it easier. You can catch a 3-day-old moon on the 21st, follow a line from Saturn in the southwest in the evening, just above Spica, through Mars here, then go 3 times that distance towards just above the western horizon. Using binoculars to scan the horizon that evening, look about 30 minutes after sunset, but you may not spot anything until 10 or 20 minutes later. Seeing the moon is easier on the 22nd, as the now higher and slightly larger crescent moon will be just 2 times the distance from Saturn to Mars. Look for Spica, Saturn, Mars, and the moon not only that evening, but in the succeeding Monday and Tuesday sky as well. Around midnight or later, don't forget that you can still spot Neptune, as I covered in last week's video. And further into the morning hours, near sunrise, the pairing of Venus and Jupiter are gaining some separation as the motion of Earth creates visual distance between the two brightest planets in our sky. Interact with Eyes on the Sky on these social networking sites. Share these videos so we can help others interested in astronomy learn what they can find and see while educating about light pollution reduction. And sincere thanks to everyone who has donated to keep these videos ad-free. Keep your eyes on the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down by using dark sky-friendly lighting fixtures so we can all see what's up.